Welcome to module 5, lecture number 4 on motion of the follower. In last lecture, we have discussed uniform velocity motion and simple harmonic motion. In this lecture, we will discuss about uniform acceleration and retardation motion and cycloidal motion. Let us start with uniform acceleration and retardation motion. In this type of motion, due to uniform acceleration or deacceleration, continuous change in velocity can be observed. In acceleration diagram, you can see follower has uniform acceleration up to midpoint and then it move with uniform deacceleration. Due to uniform acceleration, velocity is increasing from point A to E and it is decreasing from E to J. At the start and end of stroke, velocity is zero, but it is maximum at midpoint. You can see during dwell period, follower is at rest, that's why velocity is zero. And finally, during the return stroke, follower is again moving with deacceleration and acceleration, that is uniform. The magnitude of maximum velocity during outstroke and return stroke can be calculated with the help of these formulas, where V suffix O represents the velocity, maximum velocity during the outstroke, that can be calculated as 2 times omega s divided by theta O, where omega is the angular velocity of the cam and s is the stroke or lift of the follower. Theta O represents the angular displacement of cam during the outstroke. Vr represents the maximum velocity during the return stroke. It can be calculated with the help of this formula, 2 times omega s divided by theta r, where omega is the angular velocity of cam, s is the lift of follower, theta r represents the angular displacement of cam during return stroke. Similarly, maximum acceleration of follower during outstroke and return stroke can be calculated with the help of these formulas, where A suffix O represents the acceleration during the outstroke and A suffix R represents the acceleration during return stroke. Now let us see how these formulas are derived. So here, for the simplicity, only outstroke is considered. During this outstroke, there is a point P where the follower is moving at a distance h during the cam displacement theta. Now equation of motion, h is equal to ut plus 1/2 at square. This is the first equation, and second equation is v is equal to u plus at square, where this h is the displacement of follower at point P when cam turn through angle theta. T is the time, A is the acceleration, V is the final velocity, U is the initial velocity. Okay. So when the follower is moving from its lowest position to the topmost position, the initial velocity is 0. That's why we will put U is equal to 0 in equation number 1. So equation 1 becomes 1/2 at square. Now we will rearrange this equation as 2 times h is equal to at square. Now to calculate the acceleration, we will move this t square on other side. So a is equal to 2h upon t square. Label it as equation number 3. Velocity is maximum at midpoint during the outstroke, that we have seen. At midpoint P, this h is equal to 1/2 of the stroke, s by 2. And theta is equal to 1/2 of the outstroke. We know that omega is equal to theta upon t, where omega is the angular velocity, and that can be calculated as rate of change of angular displacement, that is the angular displacement is theta. We can rewrite this relation as t is equal to theta upon omega. Now we will put this value of theta in this equation, so theta o divided by 2 upon omega. This is the new value of t. Now put these values in equation number 3. So maximum acceleration during the outstroke, AO, as we are considering the outstroke, so AO is equal to 2 times h divided by t square, theta o divided by 2 upon omega bracket square. Now after simplifying the equation, we will get AO is equal to 4 times omega square s divided by theta o square. Similarly, maximum acceleration during return stroke can be calculated as AR is equal to 4 times omega square s divided by theta r square. Now we will calculate the maximum velocity during the outstroke and return stroke. For that we will use the second equation. Now put u is equal to 0 in second equation. So second equation becomes v is equal to at. V O that represents the maximum velocity during the outstroke is equal to, we will put the value of acceleration during the outstroke, that is 4 times omega square s divided by theta o square, multiplied by, we will put the t is equal to theta upon omega. Now omega omega will get cancelled, so we will get VO is equal to 4 times omega s theta divided by theta o square. Now as we are talking about the maximum velocity, so we have seen the maximum velocity is at midpoint. So at midpoint theta is equal to theta o divided by 2. Now put this value in this equation. Instead of theta we will write theta o divided by 2. Maximum velocity during outstroke is equal to 4 times omega s divided by theta o square multiplied by theta o divided by 2. Here theta o, theta o will get cancelled, and finally we will get the equation as v o is equal to 2 times omega s divided by theta o. Similarly, the maximum velocity during the return stroke can be calculated as v r is equal to 2 times omega s divided by theta r. Next motion is cycloidal motion. Let us learn this motion with the help of video. Cycloid is curve traced by point on a circle when the circle rolls without slipping on a straight line. In case of cam, the straight line is a stroke of the follower, and the circumference of the circle is equal to the stroke S. Therefore, radius of the rolling circle is, this rolling circle, radius of rolling circle is equal to s upon 2 pi, where s is the stroke of the follower. When the radius is 1, at that time the path travelled by this circle or circumference of circle will be 2 pi. For simplicity, only outstroke is shown here. Up to midpoint, velocity increases and then start decreasing. Velocity is maximum at midpoint. Now you can see the acceleration is 0 at start of the stroke and end of stroke, as well as at midpoint. The acceleration is maximum when theta is equal to theta o divided by 4, and velocity is maximum when theta is equal to theta o divided by 2. The maximum velocity of the follower on the outstroke and return stroke can be calculated with the help of these two equations. So velocity during the outstroke is equal to 2 times omega s divided by theta o, where omega is the angular velocity, s is the lift of follower, and theta o is the angular displacement of cam during the outstroke. Maximum velocity during return stroke can be calculated as 2 times omega s divided by theta r, where theta r is the angular displacement of cam during the return stroke. Similarly, maximum acceleration of follower on outstroke and return stroke can be calculated with the help of these formulas. So maximum acceleration during outstroke is equal to 2 times pi omega square s divided by theta o square, and maximum acceleration during return stroke is equal to 2 times pi omega square s divided by theta r square. Now let us see how these formulas are derived. Here, for the simplicity, only outstroke is shown, where this vertical line shows the stroke of the follower and this circle is rolling on this straight line. Now consider point P. This point P, during the outstroke, when follower travel distance O2M, this O2M distance, and cam turn through the angle theta. So this cam turn through angle theta when there is a point P on this circle. Now in triangle PCB, angle PCB is equal to alpha. P2C is the radius of the rolling circle. As P2C is the radius, with the help of trigonometry we can find the value of P2B. As this is the opposite side, so R sin alpha, and this is the adjacent side, B2C is the adjacent side, that's why it is R cos alpha. We are interested to find out the coordinates of point P in y direction and x direction. So O2D, this O2D distance is equal to arc PD. Arc PD can be calculated as radius multiplied by included angle alpha. And MD, this MD distance is equal to PB, which is equal to sine component of the radius, R sine alpha. MD is equal to PB is equal to R sine alpha. Coordinates of point P in y axis, this y is equal to OM, and OM is equal to OD minus MD. OM is equal to OD minus MD. Now OM is nothing but the y, that is the coordinate, y coordinate of the point P. O2D distance, this O2D distance we have calculated here, that is equal to R alpha minus MD is equal to R sin alpha. Y is equal to, we will take out this R, so R in bracket alpha minus sin alpha. Now coordinates of point P in x axis, this x can be calculated as PM is equal to BD is equal to x. Now BD is equal to CD minus CB. So this CD, this C2D is nothing but radius of the rolling circle, and C2B is the cos component. So C2B is equal to R cos alpha. Now x is equal to R in bracket 1 minus cos alpha. The circumference of circle, that is equal to 2 pi r. When it rolls over the straight line, then it is equal to 2 pi. The stroke of follower is equal to 2 pi r. Now we will rewrite this equation as r is equal to s upon 2 pi. From the relationship, we will find out the value of alpha. Here, when circle turns through an angle alpha, there is angular displacement theta for the cam, and when the circle completes one revolution, the angle is pi, and for the cam the angle is theta o, where the theta o is the outstroke, the angular displacement of the cam. So alpha upon theta is equal to 2 pi upon theta o. Cross multiply alpha with theta o and 2 pi with theta. So alpha is equal to 2 pi theta divided by theta o. Put it in equation number 1. This is the equation number 1. As we are talking about the motion of the rolling circle over a straight line, that is equal to the stroke. So we will consider only y motion. So y is equal to r in bracket alpha minus sin alpha. We will put alpha is equal to 2 pi theta upon theta o, and r is equal to s upon 2 pi. So s upon 2 pi in bracket 2 pi theta upon theta o minus sin in bracket 2 pi theta upon theta o. Now we will multiply this bracket inside this bracket with s upon 2 pi. So s upon 2 pi theta divided by 2 pi theta minus s upon 2 pi sin 2 pi theta upon theta o. This 2 pi 2 pi will get cancelled. So y is equal to s in bracket theta upon theta o minus 1 upon 2 pi sin 2 pi theta upon theta o. We know that omega is equal to theta upon t, where omega is the angular velocity and it is the rate of change of angular displacement. Theta is the angular displacement. We can rewrite this relation as theta is equal to omega t. Now we will put omega t instead of theta in this equation. So this equation become y is equal to s in bracket omega t divided by theta o minus 1 upon 2 pi sine of 2 pi omega t divided by theta o. Label it as equation number 2. Now maximum velocity of follower at outstroke. So maximum velocity can be calculated by differentiating the above equation. So this is the displacement equation for a displacement, and maximum velocity can be calculated by differentiating this equation. V o is equal to s in bracket omega upon theta o minus 1 upon 2 pi cos of 2 pi omega t upon theta o multiplied by 2 pi omega upon theta o. 2 pi 2 pi will get cancelled. So we will get s omega theta o in bracket 1 minus cos of 2 pi omega t upon theta o. Label it as equation number 3. Now velocity will be maximum if this cos term is equal to minus 1. So cos 2 pi theta, omega t is nothing but theta. Omega t is equal to theta. So cos 2 pi theta upon theta o is equal to minus 1. But we know that cos pi is equal to minus 1. That's why we will put cos pi instead of minus 1. And we will compare it with this equation. So 2 pi theta upon theta o is equal to pi. Now 2 pi theta is equal to pi multiplied by theta o. Now we will calculate the value of theta, that is equal to theta o divided by 2. This velocity is maximum when the theta is equal to theta o divided by 2, half of the outstroke. Now put this value in equation number 3. So if we put the value of theta is equals to theta o divided by 2, we will get VO is equal to S into omega divided by theta o in bracket 1 plus 1. So the final equation is 2 times S omega divided by theta o. Similarly, the maximum velocity of follower at return stroke can be calculated as VR is equal to 2 times S omega divided by theta r. Now maximum acceleration of follower during the outstroke can be calculated by differentiating the equation of velocity. So this is the equation of velocity. So we will differentiate this equation with respect to time. So we will get s omega divided by theta o in bracket sin 2 pi omega t theta o multiplied by 2 pi omega divided by theta o. Label it as equation number 4. Now acceleration will be maximum if this acceleration will be maximum if this sine term is 1. So sine 2 pi omega t divided by theta o is equal to 1. We know that sine pi by 2 is equal to 1. So we will put sine pi by 2 instead of 1. So we will compare this sine pi by 2 with this term. 2 pi omega t divided by theta o is equal to pi by 2. Now omega t can be replaced with the help of theta. So 4 times theta is equal to pi theta o. Finally, we will get theta is equal to theta o divided by 4. So we can say that the acceleration is maximum when theta is equal to theta o divided by 4. Now put this value in equation number 4. So this is the equation number 4. We will put the value of theta in this equation and we get AO is equal to 2 pi omega square s upon theta o square. Similarly, maximum acceleration of follower during the return stroke can be calculated as AR is equal to 2 pi omega square s divided by theta r square, where r represents the return stroke and o represents the outstroke. Thank you.